إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار قال الله تعالى كذلك لنصرف عنه السوء والفحشاء إنه من عبادنا المخلصين And thus we avert evil and immortality away from Yusuf. We shielded him. We dismissed the possibility of that evil and immortality away from him. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this verse was revealed in a situation when Yusuf alayhi salam, the youth, the stranger, was exposed to the hardest test in his journey in Egypt. The woman who owns the house and owns him, shutting all the doors and inviting him to adultery. He said no. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this fitna, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala listed the type of whims and desires that mankind have to combat, it was the top of the list. زُيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ حُبُّ الشَّهَوَاتِ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ The first. Then وَالْبَنِينَ وَالْقَنَاطِيرِ الْمُقَنْطَرَةِ مِنَ الذَّهَبِ وَالْفِضَّةِ وَالْخَيْلِ الْمُسَوَّمَةِ وَالْأَنْعَامُ وَالْحَرْثِ But this fitna, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم also said about it, كما في صحيح مسلم من حديث أسامة بن زيد رضي الله عنهما ما تركت فتنة أضر على الرجال من النساء I have not left a test that is so hard on the men of my ummah than the women the desire and only few people can be saved from that situation, finding yourself alone with a woman is something that you must avoid to begin with. Because the Prophet ﷺ mentioned that a man and a woman by themselves, shaitan is their third. And someone who actually comes out of this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made a reward for that person in the day of resurrection to be shaded under the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كما في الصحيحين من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال صلى الله عليه وسلم سبعة يظلهم الله في ظله يوم لا ظل إلا ظله رجل دعته امرأة ذات منصب وجمال فقال إني أخاف الله رب العالمين. The seven kinds of people who will be shaded under the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of resurrection, when there is no other shade but the shade of the throne of Allah, is a man who was invited by a prestigious rich woman, and he said, no, I fear Allah. But the question that we ask ourselves, brothers and sisters in Islam, is why Yusuf alayhi salam was delivered. Why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala avert, pushed away from him that fitna? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, إِنَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا الْمُخْلَصِينَ. He is one of our sincere servants. Sincerity, my brothers, can make you overcome any hardship, any distress that you may encounter in this world. بالإخلاص, if you're sincere with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in what you say and what you do, Allah always delivers you. And as a matter of fact, sometimes the hardship would turn into a grant from Allah, will be a reason for you to be elevated in the eyes of people because of your sincerity. Al-mihna tanqalibu ila minha bi-ikhlasik. Even if the master planner of the plot against you is shaitan, with your sincerity, you can overcome it. Because shaitan, Satan, at the very beginning, when he exposed his plan to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he revealed his plan, and Allah knows what his plan is without Satan's revelation of it, he said, قَالَ, he said, رَبِّ بِمَا أَغْوَيْتَنِي لَأُزَيِّنَنَّ لَهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ. My Lord, I will misguide all the offspring of Adam. وَلَأُغْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. And I will purify things for them to misguide them. Satan himself made the exception. And he said, إِلَّا I will be able to do this to all of them except إِلَّا عبادك منهم المخلصين. Accept a brand of your servants, those who are sincere. Sincerity is something between you and Allah, a personal relationship. When you do something, it's for you, O Allah, not for the people. When you say a word, it's for you, O Allah, not for the people. حتى even الكافر, a disbeliever, when he is sincere in his dua, Allah delivers him. وهو كافر أنا مسلم يكفر بالله. But when he is at a time of distress and he really calls upon Allah, Allah will deliver him if he chooses to, subhanahu wa ta'ala. في سنن النساء حديث سعد بن أبي وقاص رضي الله عنه, when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم came to Mecca, from Medina to conquer Mecca, he named certain people to be killed because of the amount of harm that they inflicted upon Muslims, because they killed a lot of Muslims. And one of those people was Ikrima ibn Abi Jahl radiallahu anhu. Ikrima, after learning that his name on that list, he fled. He got on a ship. All the people in the ship, on the ship, are kuffar, non-Muslims. A thunderstorm erupted, they are about to drown. Look at the non-Muslim captain of the ship, what he said. He said, Ayyuhan nas, Ayyuhan nas, O people, اعلموا أنه لن ينجيكم اليوم إلا الإخلاص. Nothing can spare you but sincerity now. All these idols that you pray to, prostrate to, all these showing off that you do out there is not going to help you here. Now, call upon Allah. وَإِذَا مَسَّكُمُ الضُّرُّ فِي الْبَحْرِ ضَلَّ مَنْ تَدْعُونَ إِلَّا إِيَّاهِ فَلَمَّا نَجَّاكُمْ إِلَى الْبَرِّ أَعْرَضْتُمْ وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ كَفُورًا وَإِذَا غَشِيَهُمْ مَوْجٌ كَالظُّلَلِ دعوا الله مخلصين له الدين. So, حتى الكافر, when he's sincere, أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَى. والألف واللام إذا دخلت على الاسم عموم, المضطر هنا الكافر والمسلم. Everybody, if you are at distress and you call upon Allah, Allah will deliver you. But the quality of a Muslim, the quality of a believer, that you develop sincerity in all what you do. Even when you are not at a time of distress. And that is where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told Abdullah ibn Abbas, كما في سنن الترمذي, يا غلام, oh young boy, احفظ الله يحفظك. Be mindful of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be mindful of you. Be mindful of Allah when things are going okay. Develop sincerity when things are okay. Then when you are at a time of need, at a time of distress, Allah can deliver you. اعرف اعرف الله في الرخاء يعرفك في الشدة. Get to know Allah when things are okay. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will know you when things are not okay, and he will deliver you because of your knowledge of Allah, because of your sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sincerity is a personal relationship between you and Allah. That when you say something, I'm saying it for you, Allah. When you do something, when you write something, it's for Allah. And don't try to be plastic with Allah. Allah knows what's inside you. Be truthful. Be truthful with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. في صحيح البخاري ومسلم من حديث عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما. Three individuals from Bani Israel decided to journey And the road was across the desert. Huge or very active thunderstorm erupted. Rain, lightning. وَمِنَ السُّنَّةِ. It is of the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ that you go inside. لا يغرنك. Don't be deceived by these people who come in front of the rain reporting the hurricane for you. ليس هذا من السنة. في صحيح البخاري عائشة رضي الله عنها would ask the Prophet ﷺ, يا رسول الله الناس يفرحون. People with joy when they see cloud and rain. وأرى في عينك الكراهة. وأرى في وجهك الكراهة. And I see in your face discomfort. قال وما يدريك يا عائشة. What do you know of عائشة? Some people they looked at the rain and they said, قالوا هذا عارض ممطرنا. بل هو ما استعجلتم به. ريح فيها عذاب أليم. تدمر كل شيء بأمر ربها. A person must show respect to الريح, to the thunder. Go inside and teach your children that. Now, brave, my boy is standing under. لا ينفع يا أخي, challenging Allah. هذه من آيات الله سبحانه وتعالى. For these three individuals, they decided to go inside the cave. فهبطت صخرة مما يهبط من خشية الله. Huge rock fall down, blocked their exit. There is no way for that huge rock to be pushed for them to go out. They are to die. Huge. Three of them cannot push it. In a position like this, who can deliver you? Who can deliver you? But the one who caused that rock to fall down. That rock did not fall by accident. ثم قست قلوبكم من بعد ذلك فهي كالحجارة أو أشد قسوة وإن من الحجارة لما يهبط من خشية الله. These rocks that you see sometimes they fall down because of the fear of Allah. They don't fall down in their own. So the Lord of the rock can help them. Now, يا أيها الذين آمنوا, oh you believe, اتقوا الله, have taqwa in Allah, وابتغوا إليه الوسيلة. Seek the wasila. Seek a means to invoke Allah, approach Allah, but not the dead. Not the dead. Not go to a graveyard and invoke the dead to no. Seek Allah with His names. ادعوا الله بأسمائه. بأسمائه, His names, His attributes, the means, your iman in Allah. And one of these means is your righteous deeds. So they said, each one of us now has to come up with a deed that you thought that you did it for Allah, that you had sincerity. And this goes into these brothers who say that مَنْ رَأَى فِي عَمَلِهِ الْإِخْلَاصِ فَإِخْلَاصُهُ يَحْتَاجُ إِلَى إِخْلَاصِ. هذا كلام ما ينفع, كلام دروشة, هذا ما ينفع, لا محله من الإعراب. Oh, these people right here, they will actually cite deeds that they did and they sensed sincerity in it, and they will see a practical evidence that this deed was sincere. The first one started telling the story. Allahumma innaka ta'lam. Oh Allah, you know that I used to be a shepherd. كنت أرعى الغنم. And I used to have two old parents, elders. And I used to be so dutiful to them. So kind to them. Wallahi, by Allah, I have never seen someone so kind to his parents like this man. Look what he used to do. He comes at night, he would milk his sheep, prepare a drink for his father and mother, ghamuq, and he would go, give them the drink, and put them to sleep. Every day. Before giving a drink to his children. For one day, one of his sheep ran away. He has to look for the sheep. He arrived home late. He found his father and mother, the elders, asleep. خلاص ناموا مش مشكلة. لا. You know, it really breaks my heart to receive a call from a mother telling my son is telling me the F word, Imam. My son hit me, Imam. When we repeat, we say, Ya Jama'a, I call the son. Oh, my mom is mean to me. She's mean to me. Tab undur. The level of the relationship between the children and the parents is called ihsan. Ihsan. And I'm speaking to the youth. What is ihsan, akhi? If she slaps you here, you tell her, please. Please. هذا هو الإحسان. ووصينا الإنسان بوالديه. What? إحسان. Level إحسان. A young man cannot say, well, my father did not take a good care of me, so I have to get back. إزاي يا راجل؟ إحسان. إحسان. Look at this man. He's a shepherd. And you may be taking that word shepherd lightly. رعي الغنم هذا teaches patience and teaches forbearance. It's a very difficult job. ولذلك therefore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would get the prophets and the messengers to do it before they become prophets and messengers. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في البخاري بحديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه ما من نبي إلا ورع الغنم وكنت أرعاها على قراريط لأهل مكة. Every prophet and messenger used to shepherd in order to learn patience with the people and forbearance. Tough job. He milked his sheep. He carries the drink in his hand. Standing by his asleep parents, elders. His children are crying underneath him and refusing to give them a drink until his parents would wake up at the time when they wake up and he would give them the drink. فَأَعْطَيْتُهُمَا غَمُوقَهُمَا فِي وَقْتِ الصَّبُوحِ. He said, I given them the drink at night in the morning. He stood up all night long waiting for his parents to wake up. I mean, you don't have to do that. But why did he do that? He was showing off. His parents are asleep. He's showing off to his young children who are crying for a drink. Oh Allah, if I was sincere, if I was sincere, oh Allah, when I did this deed, and you know, then move this rock. Sincerity moved a rock. The rock moved. before their eyes. Sincerity. Sincere with Allah. But not enough for the three of them to go out. Not enough. Small. The second one, subhanallah, he got exposed to the fitna of the women, like Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam. Allahumma innaka ta'lam, oh Allah, you know, annahu kanat li ibnatu am. I had a cousin. يعني فتنة النساء هذه العشق والهوى والكلام هذا مشكلة. When a man's heart get consumed by a woman, he becomes her slave. He becomes a slave. داء العشق. داء هذا داء. This is a disease. What they sing for you in the movies is a disease. And you read these stories. Somebody, prince who was supposed to be a king, and he fall in love with the women, and he giving up the kingship for the women. Cleopatra, Antonio, Layla, Aziza. A mark of shame هذه عند الرجل. إذا كلف الرجل بحب امرأة يخرج من ماله يخرج من سلطانه. Because his heart is consumed. فهذا الرجل fall into that fitna. My cousin, I was brought up with her. I was so كنت أحبها. I used to love her. أشد ما يحب الرجال النساء. More than any man loving a woman. And look at the fitna now. She gets married to somebody else. And he used to be a rich man. Her and her husband, they run through a financial crisis. They wanted help. عايزين قرض. They wanted a loan. Of course, she has a wealthy cousin. It makes sense to ask him. She approached him. Can you give me a loan, please? No. Unless I have you. I want to commit adultery with you and I'll give you what you want. I'm married. No. I want you. A chaste woman. Afifa. She left him. She went away. Please, alone. Please, alone. Please, alone. Please. Nobody helped her. That is why in Islam we have the institution of zakah. I tell you, a lot of people, they steal, commit adultery, because we are negligent of giving them their rights in our wealth. She had to come back to him. But she did something that out of this world. The man narrates, he says, فَجَلَسْتُ مِنْهَا. I sat next to her like a man would sit next to his wife. And then she said this to me. اتَّقِ اللَّهِ. Fear Allah. Fear Allah. وَلَا تَفُضَّ الْخَاتَمَ إِلَّا بِحَقِّهِ. It's unlawful for you to do this. فَقُمْتُ عَنْهَا. As soon as she reminded me with Allah, of Allah, I stood up. وَهِيَ أَحَبُّ النَّاسِ إِلَيْهِ. And I was so much craving for this. But I feared you. And it was not the money. I left her with the money. I left the money there. هذا إخلاص. This is sincerity. This man did this for Allah. Because there is no third to them but Allah. Oh Allah, if I was sincere, help us out and remove this rock. The rock moved. Amalun yuharriku hajar. Ikhlas. Sincerity. That moves a rock for you. A rock that three cannot move. The third one, fitnatul mal, the fitna of money. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, inna fitnata ummatil mal, the fitna of my ummah is the money, the love of the money. وَتُحِبُّونَ الْمَالَ حُبًّا جَمًّا. And you love money so much. وَإِنَّهُ لِحُبِّ الْخَيْرِ لَشَدِيدٍ. الخير هير مش مقام مدح, ده مقام ذم. ذم. He loves money. الخير هير means money. He loves money so much. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في البخاري, يهرم ابن آدم. The son of Adam will become so old. He's ويصغر قلبه في أمري. And his heart grows younger in two areas. طول الأمل وحب المال. He want a long life. He want to live a long life. And he want money. So you'll find him old, about to fall down, but his heart is young. In those two areas. He want to live. And he want to accumulate more money. يقول ابن آدم مالي مالي. What money will do? But if you see, hear these people. Some guy having $300 million. What are you going to do with $300 million? What are you going to do with it? Huh? يقول ابن آدم مالي 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 مالي. The son of Adam says مالي. What is your mal, the son of Adam? What can you use the money for? One. To eat. Digest, process, azzakumullah, eat again. Can you eat 100 meals at the same meal? It's one meal. Can you fill 100 stomachs? It's one stomach. Can you drive 5-6 cars at the same time? Even if you have the 5-6 cars, one car only. وَمَا مَالُكَ يَا ابْنَ آدَمْ. What is your money, the son of Adam? Except what you eat, digest, and what you wear. Wash, wear, wash, buy another one. And what you spend for the cause of Allah, so that you will find it in the next life. وَمَا أَنْفَقْتَ فَأَبْقَيْتَ. They take social security number from us here at the age of, you get it at 65. طب مين اللي حيعيش قبلني لو عشنا 65. النبي يقول لك عمر أمتي بين 60 و70. طيب. Give to the hereafter, the eternal life. Eternal life. You find the businessman these days, he has all type of consultants. Feasibility study. A loan officer. A consultant in this area. And a consultant. But Imam, Sheikh, to call him. Sheikh, is this deal is haram or halal? لا. ولا. ولا حياة لمن تنادي ولا حياة وش واحنا ببلاش اصلا ده شيخز ار بلاش فري ذات كونسلتنت از جونا تشارج يو 300,000 ذا امام از ببلاش يو دونت جيف هيم ماني فور ذا كونسل بات هي دازنت كول هي دازنت كير ليس ليه حب المال فتنه المال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم سوى والله باي الله ما الفقر اخشى عليكم. By Allah, I do not fear poverty for you, my ummah. But the other side of it, but riches. أن تفتح عليكم الدنيا فتنافسوها كما تنافسوها فتهلككم كما أهلكتهم. هكذا. Businessman hired some people to do a job for him. Listen to this carefully. Just to compare this businessman with our businessmen now, Muslim businessmen. He told them, listen, I'm giving each one of you a wage. A daily wage. You work from 7 to 7, you're getting so much. One of the people did not get it. He thought if he works double, he will get double. So at the end of the day, he's giving each one his wage. فَرْقٌ مِنْ أَرُزْ Handfuls of rice. وَفِي رِوَيَ ذُرَى فَهِ came to this man who worked double. Said, يَا هَذَا So and so, اتَّقِ اللَّهِ I worked twice, I need twice. He said, no. It's fair to everybody. He got upset. He said, I don't want. And he left. He did not take his wage. Any businessman would say, Baraka ya jami'. Just added to La. Mukhlas hadha. Yata'amal ma'a rabbihi. He took that handful seeds, planted it in the ground. With the harvest, listen to this, sold it in the market, bought a sheep, pregnant, babies, cows, years went by. Those handfuls of rice or corn, they turned into a valley filled with animals. And he would take care of the animals, deliver the animals, and feed the animals. And this man, years later, he ran out of business. ما فيش فلوس معه. فهذا بقول له إن الخواجة لما بفلس. يعني he checks when you run out of money, you start checking your old books. A dollar here and there to make it. Well, let me go back and collect my wage. I need it now. So he went to the businessman. يا هذا أو سو أن سو اتق الله fear Allah and give me my wage. He said, come. Let's go to the top of this hill. You see that valley? That's yours. يا الله. He looked at him. يا عبد الله لا تسخر مني. O servant of Allah, do not mock me. Do not make fun out of me. Just give me my wage. Let me go. He said, Wallahi, this is yours. يا إخوة والله this man أنا بحثت في روايات هذا الحديث I did not find one wording of this hadith that the man left 10% to the businessman he took it all ما سبلوش حتى بقرة ولا he would محتسب he did this for Allah خلاص oh Allah if I was sincere Deliver me. Move the truck. The rock moved. But before I conclude, I ask you a question. If you were there fourth, and for the truck to allow them to exit, you also have to come with a deed that you done sincerely for Allah. Can you think of one? Can you? I'm talking to you. Can you think of a deed that you think you done it for Allah? أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله Brothers and sisters in Islam Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to be delivered also in the day of resurrection. And in a beautiful surah that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recommended for us to recite every Friday. The surah ends with a beautiful verse where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses everyone. فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. If you're after the meeting with Allah in the day of resurrection, you better prepare one deed. عَمَلًا. It's not plural. It's not أعمال. عَمَلًا. One deed that you do sincerely for Allah. One deed. Just one deed. Sincerely for Allah. That is your mission. That is your mission. To do one deed for Allah sincerely, so that it can save you. Not only in the dunya, also in the hereafter. فنسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يرزق أن يرزقنا الإخلاص في القول والعمل والسر والعلن. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواه. زكها أنت خير من زكاه. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة.